A bag contains four balls, and two balls are drawn at random and are found to be white. What is the probability that all balls are white? So, if two balls are already found to be white, out of four balls, correct? Two balls are already white. So, what are the different possibilities? Either all four balls can be white, or only three of the four balls can be white, or only two of the four balls can be white, correct? So, if I call this as event E1, event E2, and event E3, now, since nothing is mentioned about what are the number of colors that the balls can have or anything, nothing is mentioned, so therefore, I can assume that these two are equally likely events. So, E1, E2 and E3 are equally likely, correct? And also, they are mutually exclusive, because if it has 4 balls, then it cannot have just 3 balls. So, they are mutually exclusive, and they are also exhaustive, because these are the only 3 possibilities that can be there. Because we already know that 2 balls are white, that means that there is no other possibility left, and they are also exhaustive. Okay. So, if 3 events are if they are equally likely, then I can tell that probability of E1 is equal to probability of E2 is equal to probability of E3, correct? And since there are 3 events, they are exhaustive events, so each of them are equally likely means probability of occurrence of any one of them is simply 1 by 3. Okay, so I got that probability of E1 is equal to E2 equal to E3 equal to 1 by 3. Now, let us say I call this as my event A, that 2 balls drawn are white. Okay. Now, I need to find the probability of occurrence of E3 given A. Right? This is what I have to find. Now, I cannot determine it because there is no other data given to me. But, if I am given that E3 is true, that means there are only, probability of occurrence of E1 given A. For this also there is no data, so I cannot tell it. So, now, but I can tell the other things, that is, probability of occurrence of event A given E1 is true, or probability of occurrence of event A given E2 is true, and probability of event A given E3 is true. I can tell all these three values, and I also know probability of E1, E2 and E3. So, if I can find out these three values, then I can use the Bayes theorem. What does the Bayes theorem tell that? It tells us that if E1 and E2 and E3 are mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, then probability of occurrence of event E1 given A is equal to probability of occurrence of A given E1 into probability of E1 divided by probability of A given E1 into probability of E1 plus probability of A given E2 into probability of E2 plus probability of A given E3 into probability of E3. Correct? This is what is the Bayes theorem. So, if I want to use this theorem, I have to find out these three values. Now, if I consider this one, the first one, then probability of occurrence of event A given E1 is true. E1 is true means all the four balls in the bag are white. So, if all the four balls are white, then probability of getting two white balls, when you take out two balls, is simply 1, because under all circumstances, whichever ball you take, it will be white. So, probability of A given E1 is 1. Or I can tell it as total number of ways in which I can pick up two balls, two white balls is 4c2, and total number of ways in which I can pick up two balls is 4c2. So this is equal to 1. Similarly, if there are three white balls, then what is the total number of ways in which I can take up two white balls? That is 3c2, and total number of ways of picking up two balls is 4c2. So 3c2 by 4c2 will be 3c2 is equal to 3 into 2 by 2 divided by 4 into 3 by 2. So I can cancel this 2 and I can cancel this 3. So I am left with 2 by 4, which is equal to half. And similarly, probability of occurrence of event A given E3. That means if there are only 2 white balls in the bag, then the probability of taking out 2 white balls when you draw 2 balls is simply 2c2, because there is only one way in which you can select 2 white balls, divided by total number of ways of selecting 2 balls is 4c2, which is equal to 2c2 is 1 divided by 4c2 is 4 into 3 by 2. Now 2 into 2 is 4, so this is equal to 1 by 6. So I found out probability of A given E2, E1, E2 and E3. That is 1, half and 1 by 6. And I also know these values. So if I put all these values into this expression, then I will get it as probability of E given A, E1 given A. That is probability of all the balls are white. 4 balls are white given event A has occurred. That is what I have to find. So this is equal to A1 into 1 by 3 divided by 1 into 1 by 3 plus half into 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 into 1 by 3. Correct? So 1 by 3 I can cancel from numerator and denominator because it is there in every term. So this is equal to 1 by 1 plus half plus 1 by 6. So if I multiply numerator and denominator by 6, then it is 6 by 6 plus half into 6 is 3, and half 6 into 1 by 6 is 1. So this is equal to 6 by 6 plus 3 plus 1 is 10, which is equal to 0.6. This was probability of occurrence of event E1 given event A has occurred is 0.6. Therefore, this is my final answer.